Everybody, welcome back to another reaction video. Hope you're doing well. My name is Todd. This is Sense 8, What's Going On? I have not reacted to this show before, so interested to see what it's like. This is requested by a Patreon subscriber. You too can join the Patreon link down below in the description. We'll get you there. Throw a like on the video if you like it. Subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Hit that notification bell. That way you know when videos post immediately, and you can come check them out. And let's go. All right, since I don't know what it is, time to read a little blurb about it. Now, I read one of these previously, and you all got kind of a kick out of it, because it's on the, what is it, fandom.com, so it's not an official synopsis. It was written by a fan, so I'm not exactly sure if it's accurate or not, but we'll figure it out. Sense 8 is an American science fiction drama thriller web television series. Boy, that's a mouthful. Created by the Wachowskis, who created The Matrix, which started airing on Netflix 2015. The story revolves around eight strangers from different parts of the world who suddenly become mentally and emotionally linked due to an unknown evolutionary leap. Interesting. It explores subjects that its writers felt sci-fi shows tend to ignore, such as politics, identity, sexuality, gender, and religion. Yeah, I'd say that's accurate. As the, mostly it's just to do with, you know, whatever monsters hunting people or Star Trek, you know, just figuring out what's going on out there. As the sensates attempt to sort out why they became linked and what it means for them and for the future of mankind, a mysterious figure named Jonas works to bring the eight together, while another stranger, simply called Whispers, and his organization try to hunt down and capture or assassinate them. Interesting. There's always got to be a bad person hunting somebody. And I'm assuming the majority of the show is just them trying to figure out what the heck's going on, what caused this, why are they like this, what's the implication, what purpose does it hold for mankind? I mean, I don't know. That certainly gives a little glimpse into it. Now let's go ahead and watch.
Ah, oh, come on.
Indeed.
Hey. 25 years and my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope. I realized quickly when I knew I should that the world was made up of this brotherhood of man, for whatever that means. Into a crisis times when I'm lying in bed, just you get
this song is so classic.
That would be freaky.
This is what life is. Fear, rage, desire. Love. I take everything I'm feeling, everything that matters to me. I push all of it into my fist, and I fight for it.
And I try. Oh my God, do I try? I try all the
ocean. And I pray, oh my God, do I pray? I pray to save the day for the revolution. Into a place of times when I'm lying in bed, just to get it all out, what's in my head. And I am feeling a little peculiar. Into a wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high and I scream from the top of my lungs, what's going on?
And I say, brought a gun to a bazooka fight. So the question is, obviously it looks like they see them. Do they actually meet in real life, or do they just kind of see them in their vision? I'm assuming they see each other in person, eventually.
I want everyone in this room to know that I see you. I believe in you. And as long as we're together, I know that there's nothing we can't do.
25 years and my life is still
interesting.
Time to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination.
Interesting. They're all kind of connected, living their lives, seeing each other, feeling each other. But what is going on? What is the point? That's the question. Gonna have to watch it to find out. Link down below in the description for the original video. Go throw it some love. Well, that definitely seems like an interesting concept of a show. I saw when I was looking for the plot or the description that it was canceled, which not exactly sure why. It was on Netflix, so it probably got a decent amount of people watching it. A year later, returned for a 2.5 hour long series finale. Interesting. So it was kind of like ended with a movie almost. It's actually really cool. They gave him that chance to kind of wrap up some of the loose ends. A lot of shows don't get that, so that was pretty cool that they allowed that. Kind of reminds me of Community, where it was canceled by NBC, and then who picked it up after NBC? I can't remember, but somebody picked it up, and they actually went on for a couple more seasons. Now, the later seasons weren't very good, but it was nice that they allowed them to continue it, because it was a loyal fan base for that show. Judging by just reading that, it sounds like Sense8 had a really loyal fan base as well, so it's nice that they allowed them to do that. I guess the massive question is, why were they like that? And did they ever meet each other? I'm assuming they hopefully met each other in the series finale. I'm sure there was some sort of testing being done by that mysterious shadow organization, and they wanted to find the people to either eradicate it because it was not what they intended, or they were trying to find them so they could do tests on them and capture them and whatever. A couple guesses there. Not exactly sure. I'm glad there's some shows out there kind of pushing the bounds of sci-fi. That's very cool and very neat. Link down below in the description for the Patreon. Thanks so much for watching this with me. I appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.